Good morning. Out of all the things that you've changed in this new year, your diet, your workout plan, your finances, try changing your heart. I never knew how much I loved the story of Iron Man until the movies actually came out. I've always liked the comic books, but when you look at the movie, you get a better picture of the great adversity that Tony Stark had to go through in order to become Iron Man. One day, as he's riding with his convoy of military bodyguards, Tony Stark, who is a famous weapons maker, is riding through some country and terrorists attack his convoy in order to kill him because his weapons kill people. But instead of killing him, they set off a bomb that actually sends shrapnel to his chest and is sinking closer and closer into his chest to his heart, where eventually he will die. When they realized that they did not kill him, they decided to kidnap him, that they were going to hold him hostage in order to get him to make weapons for them so that they can destroy their enemies. Tony Stark gets the help of some people around him in order to continue to live, and what he realizes is that an electromagnet helps his heart to keep pumping even though the shrapnel is getting closer and closer and closer to his heart. Eventually, Tony realizes one thing. He realizes, I need a new heart if I'm going to keep on living. He realizes that whatever is affecting his heart is getting closer and closer and closer to the point where eventually it will kill him. And what he needs to do is remove the old heart, put in a brand new heart. But where do you get a heart from when you're in captivity? He made something called an arc reactor, or the prototype of it. And that was his new heart. Not only did it keep him living, but it actually made him stronger, and it gave him the powers to become Iron Man. This is a beautiful story because this is the same story for all of us who were sinking deep in sin. We were attacked by sin, and it was creeping closer and closer and closer to our hearts. And eventually, it will do what shrapnel and sin does. It will kill you. May not kill you physically, but definitely will eternally and spiritually. And so we have to do the same thing that Tony Stark did. We have to exchange the old heart for a new heart. Because when we have a new heart, it gives us power that we never had before. It gives us the power to walk right, the power to talk right, the power to be who we never were before. And we are just as unstoppable as Iron Man. Here's what the Bible says in Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 26. And a new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you, and I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you an heart of flesh. That's what God desires to do for each and every person that comes to Him in faith. He desires to give each and every one of us a new heart. But first, He has to take away the old heart. He has to make us better. He has to make us brand new. It's going to be painful. But in this new year, I've determined that I've done some great things in 2020. But this year, I'm going forward with a new heart. I want to feel what God feels. I want to love what God loves. I want to hate what God hates. I want a new heart. So, Father, I pray that You would do spiritual surgery on our hearts and make us brand new. Clean us up and make us more like You. Search our hearts, God, because You know whether we're right and whether we're wrong. And we want to be righteous in Your sight. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. This has been Pastor Brandon M. Spriggs from the Zion Hill Agape Baptist Church in Capitol Heights, Maryland. Please like me on Facebook. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Watch me on YouTube. Until next time, keep advancing the kingdom.